Good evening, everybody. I'm Bharati NS, Assistant Professor, Department of Commerce. I'm glad to welcome you all for the day three session of the four-day national level online workshop on enhancement of research skills, organized by SSMRV College. I request you all to follow certain guidelines all over the session. Make sure you have stable internet connection. Kindly off your video and audio once you join the session. Use chat box for asking questions. Keep the questions relevant to the topic, subject matters only. Check system configuration if any further grievances are there regarding the app. So today's topics for discussion are as follows: methods, tools, and techniques for data analysis, softwares used for review of literature, referencing, and citation. So welcome you all again for the day three session. I request Mrs. Shobha, Assistant Professor, Department of Commerce, to introduce the resource person for the day three and four, Mr. Srinidhi. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Bharati, madam. Good evening, everyone. I am Shobha, Assistant Professor in the Department of Commerce. It's a great pleasure for me to introduce Mr. Srinidhi VR, resource person for third and fourth day of national level webinar on enhancement of research skills. Presently, he is working in Jain University, CMS, Bangalore. His research areas are finance and human resources. Presently, he is a reviewer for Journal of Financial Economic Policy. Apart from this, he has been invited as a resource person for conferences and seminar. To name a few, he was invited as a resource person for a FDP on approaches to research methodology in survey data analysis through R software held at SBM Jain Evening College, Bangalore. He was also invited as a resource person for a FDP on progressive research framework in social science research on how to write research paper for Scopus Journal held at T. John College, Bangalore. He was a session chair for an international conference on innovations and human values organized by Seshadripuram College, Bangalore. He was invited as a resource person for state-level students research seminar at St. Joseph College of Commerce, Bangalore. He was also invited as a resource person for the national conference on impact of digitalization on commerce, management, science, technology, and humanities organized by Noble Group of Institutions. With this brief introduction, now I request Srinidhi sir to take over the session. Over to Srinidhi sir.
Namaste, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Namaste, sir. Welcome.
Yeah, thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Namaste to all participants. Let me start with presenting and sharing my window. Okay. Yeah, ready. Can you able to see my screen share?
Yes, sir. We are able to.
So, namaste to all, and welcome for third day of enhancing research skill. Okay. So, let us first understand what is namaste, because namaste has got its relevance now because of COVID-19. Remember, namaste means namaha te. It's out of two words, namaha and te. Namaha means you are better than me. Namahate. Okay. So namaste means you are better than me. So looking at you, I still think that I'm a student of research. I still, you know, want to learn so many things. I want to explore. I know nothing. And you know, I don't have any uniqueness. And I'm just, whatever I know now, I will share with you. Probably, I think always the other person is better than me. So that is what I will use always, the word namaste. So namahate, namaste, that is you are better than me. So we are moving on to, you know, enhancement of our research skill. Today we'll be discussing on tools in research. and research proposal. And before moving on with my talk, can I interact with a few participants? Can I able to? Gokul sir? Shobha ma'am?
Yes, sir.
So, yeah. So I would like to interact with my friends who are there. Why? Because it's 2 hours just talking on one side will become very difficult for me as well as for you, because you have to keep on listening. It becomes very difficult. So let us have some brainstorming sessions and let us have some activities so that we can go ahead. So my next slide will be, so what did we learn from previous discussion? So please, any one of you can tell about it. So one of you can unmute and tell me about what did we learn from 2 days workshop of review of literature or whatever. So yeah.
Good evening, Srinidhi sir, and good evening, participants. So, can any of you type in the chat box who's the one who would want to speak, so that we can unmute yourself and speak, so that not everybody starts speaking.
So I want one of them to.
Yes.
Talk.
The participants we have.
Yeah. Kiran Hiremat. Ma'am, can you speak?
Kiran, did
yes, sir.
Yeah, can you tell us about?
I think the sir stressed the importance of literature review before you start doing your research, and there is a profound impact of literature review on whatever work research you're going to carry on. And what I liked the most is that the way he spoke about various types of plagiarism.
Okay.
And that part I really loved it, because we see plagiarism only in a particular way. And here he spoke about various dimensions of plagiarism. So literature review, of course, as I've done one or two papers, so I realized the importance of, literature review, and also he spoke about the theoretical framework, which is very important. So this is what I.
Okay. What paper you did, ma'am? If you don't mind, can you quickly explain us about your paper?
They are really basic papers. Like I've done one on corporate governance. I'm doing on behavioral finance. In fact, I have a few doubts which I would like to ask you.
Okay, that part we will discuss later on, ma'am.
Yeah.
Doubt we'll keep it up later on. And Dilip Kumar sir, can you little bit explain me about what did we learn in the last 2 days? Dilip Kumar sir, Sarfaraz sir, you are talking something. Sarfaraz sir. Saraswati ma'am, anyone else? Pradeep, yes. Pradeep sir.
Hello sir, good morning. Good evening sir, I'm Saraswati Satish. I'm doing I finished my MPhil recently in your Jain University only sir. And I'm now at present I'm pursuing a PhD in Jain University itself. Sir, from past two classes, it was really a wonderful session, sir. We learned so many things. Of course, Shastri sir has explained us so many things, but some very detailed explanation I had not underwent. So, sir, from past 2 days, he explained each and everything. As ma'am said about plagiarism, we had one different concept in our mind, but sir explained how to use the how they will see the plagiarism and what are the different steps of research. How to questionnaire, sir, especially questionnaire. When I did my MPhil, I did on demonetization and its impact on informal sector in Bangalore, sir. When I went for with questionnaire, when I went to collect the information in informal sector, I faced so many difficulties, sir. about income and all. When I checked, I really faced so many problems. Like, sir, in the yesterday, he explained how to make the questionnaire, how to collect the information from the respondent without hurting them. And even we are also not get hurt at all those things. It was very nice, sir. It was a wonderful session.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. How about Sarfaraz, sir? I think he unmuted and then muted again. Sarfaraz, sir? Okay, right. So we have learned a little bit about. I will let me go ahead with further, ideas about. So we learned in the last class that how to, prepare ROL and how it should be. What is plagiarism, and then how, what types of plagiarisms are there? Okay. So let us look into tools today. We'll look at what are the research tools available, and let us see. Hope I can clear all your doubts. Okay, so I will pray to God, and then I will continue here onwards. Let us see how does. And I request all of you to keep some sheets. And I think have you downloaded the materials which has been sent to you yesterday? Any one participant can answer.
Sir, it is not able to download, sir, and it is not able to open also. From yesterday, I'm trying to open it, sir. The link is not able to open.
Zip folder.
Yes, sir. Yeah. Not all the three links which was sent in mail is not able to open, sir. Not able to open and download also.
Okay. So any one of you could do it?
But today, when whatever was sent through WhatsApp, I could download it.
Yeah. Okay. Even so how about others? Same problem with all of you?
No, sir, we were able to download it.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. Thank you. So I think that majority of you could able to do it. So you can try meanwhile when I go with first slide or second slide, because third slide onwards we'll have some activities, because it becomes very difficult to keep on talking for 2.5 hours. So that I want, because we will make this virtual classroom as a classroom itself. So we would try to. So that is why I want all your cooperation, so that we will learn and we will, share our thoughts, because none of us are, you say I'm not, better than you, or you are actually better than me. I'm going to learn from you, actually. I'll put up our, I've done some slides. So let us look at how we can prepare based on these slides. So next one, what we are going to do now. So there are three P's in research, very important. These three P's we have to remember. What is the first P speaks about? Prepare. So you have to prepare a research article. So basically what happens, I will not concentrate on thesis right away. So why? Because this thesis is later comes. Why? Because when you go for thesis, they will ask you how many papers you have presented. When you go for submitting the thesis, or when you go for doctoral meetings, they will ask you how many paper you have published, how many paper you have presented. So first, I will not concentrate on thesis. Let me see how much I will be able to clear your doubts on the thesis. I will try. So, and if, I think so, there are a lot many doctorate holders who are there. If I am wrong, please do correct me. Okay. So, right. So prepare. First P is you have to prepare. Prepare for, we will go for article right now. So when we go for research article, how it will be, because we will go with research proposal. Probably in the meantime, I'll speak about research proposal. As we go on, we will discuss on research proposal. So prepare. First, we need to prepare ourselves. And second, we need to prepare our research paper. Okay, so that's what we are going to study today, or we are going to learn today, looking at these slides, how we can prepare our research paper. We will get ready for our final PhD thesis, or further after PhD thesis, how we can do our paper the best. Okay, next, once you prepare it, it is always better to present. How do I present it? Go for some conference. Let it be. Choose a good conference. Don't go for all conference. So think about good conferences. So go to the good conferences. When you go to good conferences, what happens? You mainly look for critics on your paper. So look at the critics. When you look at the critics, what happens? You try to note down all those critics and then try to incorporate those critics into your paper before it goes to publishing. Okay, so once you prepare your paper, try go for presentation. So present it and then go for publication. Okay, that would be the better way of doing research than just directly publishing it. Okay, so that is what 3 pieces of research which I thought about. Okay, so first you will go for preparation of your paper, then you go for presenting it in some conference. If not, no problem, you can have your own research friends, you can collaborate it, and then you can start discussing with them and you can start presenting to them. And then in this you should be very careful, because there'll be a lot of people who will be stealing your ideas. So you should choose such a kind of group which cooperates with your papers or research ways. So present it with them or with some certain colleges, certain institutions which will come out for conferences, then you go for publication of it. So this would be better. Next would be research process. Now when we look at the research process, okay, when you look at research process, first thing which comes to our mind is title. Looking at the title, searching for a title. Now how do I search for a title, or how do I frame a title? Okay, so I will search my title through either insight within me, I will get, okay, the God will tell me within me, or the mind will tell me, okay, look about so and so, you may be interested in stock market, you may be interested in human resource, you might be interested in marketing. In that what? In the stock market, you might be, in that finance, you might be interested in stock market, or it might be interested in behavioral finance, what? So I will look at the broad area first. When I look at the broad area, then I will search for some literatures. Look at some literature relevant to that. Okay? You have a lot of free websites available to search your literature. You can look at, you. Many of you will be knowing SSRN would be the best website which will give you a lot of papers you can go through, you can run through. So a lot of things you can do it. So go with certain review of literature related to what you have thought. So again, you have to come back, you have to frame a title. So you have downloaded around 50 literatures. Out of 50 literatures, you have studied around 10. Out of 10, you liked around 3. Okay, so now let us, what we do, we will copy the same title, but we have to segregate. We are looking at the same title, we like this so-and-so title, but I have to be a little bit different from what he has done. That is what research is all about, right? So what I will do, I will look at the title. Now I have looked at 50 literature, I have downloaded initially to write an article or a research paper. Now in this 50, I liked around 10. In that 10, I read around 10, and then in that 10, I have liked the most 5. So in this 5, will help me to frame a title. Okay, so once I frame the title, again I'll go back to review of literature. Now I'll start collecting more and more. Okay, so you need maybe 100 plus or 150 or 200, maybe 35 or 40, 50 review of literature. So it depends again on what you're looking at. So we will see how much review of literature actually you require. Okay, so right now I'm not giving anything. It might be 100 plus or 200 plus or 30 plus or 10 plus. I don't know right now. When we go to the slide, if such a slide comes, definitely I will explain you how much review of literature we require for any article to be, or any research paper to be, or thesis to be published, or presented, or we have to carry ahead with that. So once we do with the title, we with the review of literature, then we go with the research question. How do we find research question? Research question we have to frame through earlier studies. Okay, so frame through earlier studies. I'll go through earlier studies, I'll find out some questions which are hinting at me, or probably when you go through review of literature, they would have given scope of further research. That scope of further research can act as an objective, or it can be a research question for our it will be input. So it is always better when you study review of literature, look first for what they have not covered, that is scope of further research. That is very important for us when we look at any review of literature. Why? It is a input for our research question and objective. Next would be, once we look at, once we framed our research question and objective, then we go with data analysis. Now objective. Now when we look at objective, this objective should be how many objectives? We should have 5 objectives, 3 objectives, or 1 objective. Actually speaking, it is only 1 objective. When you look at it, one objective, that one objective is divided or classified into 2 or 3 or 4. So that means what? First objective should have a link to final objective. Similarly, second objective should have a link to final objective. Third objective should have a link to final objective. So please mute yourself.
Can the participants please mute yourself? Participants, please mute yourself.
Yeah, thank you. So objective. So you will have only one objective basically discussing on. One objective, you will search the final word, the word. That's what you're going to search for. So for that, what you do, you divide that, break into different, you know, statements. So there is a thin line exists between research question and objective. Okay. So it should not be, you know, research question should not be far away from your objective. It should be near to your objective. Okay. It should basically give you some hints about your objective. So research question, out of research question, you should get objective. Next, data analysis. We will look at data analysis in detail when we go ahead with. Okay. So data analysis is very important. Now what happens? Now, once you look at the data analysis, once you complete your data analysis, you will go to the step 5, finding and conclusion. Now, once you finding and conclusion, you will do again, you have to come back in the reverse order. Okay, so this finding and conclusion basically depends on your data analysis. Remember, what data analysis you get output out of data analysis, that should be your finding and conclusion. And the finding and conclusion, you should never draw like our MCOM students or BBA students we draw. Okay, we will never, such a, on those lines, we should not do it. We should see, we have done the review of literature. We have seen the review of literature. When we have seen the review of literature, what he has not found, that we have to get. Those things we have to find out basically. So we have, if you can able to prove what he has not got, or you can able to prove his further scope of research in your finding, so that would be the enough. Actually, I would say that would be the great. So next we will move it with conclusion. When we go with conclusion, remember, in the conclusion, do not include any statistical values in the conclusion. Conclusion should be layman. Layman should be able to understand. When he, you know, reach your conclusion, he should be able to understand, yes, I understood entire research. So it should be like that. That should be the way conclusion should be mentioned. Do not mention anything, majority, minority, nothing. So conclusion should be drawn in very normal way. And you can, you know, bring in certain citations. If that is positive, if it is negative, both you can bring in your conclusion. So what is research now? Research is from unknown to known. We move on. It is an adventurous activity for us, where we move from unknown. We have started from unknown. We took some title and then we started. We searched some ROL. We went through research question. We framed looking at the ROL. Then we did some objective. Then we went to data analysis. Then we applied some tools and techniques. And then we got finding and conclusion. Again, we are coming back to title. Why? We have to fine tune. The title should definitely match your conclusion or finding. So if it does not, we have to rewind, and then, you know, we have to change our title, or we have to tune our title according to our finding and conclusion. So research is not just from one step to fifth step or 1 to 5. It is not like that. The research is, okay, 5 to 1, 1 to 5. So you have to move like that. Next. Okay, I want, you can put it on the chat box. This is a question for you. Research is what it should be. Research is searching again and again, finding solution to any problem, working in a scientific way to search for truth of any problem. None of these. So what is research? I would like to know about the answer about this question. Can you put it in the chat? Yeah. See, Rohini says about, see, Priya says about, B. Priya ma'am, okay, Manjunath, see, okay. Safura sir says A. Okay, I want Priya ma'am to unmute and speak about why you chose B. Priya ma'am, are you here? Can you able to hear me? Can you tell me why did you chose B?
Yes, sir.
So
yeah. Can you show me that slide, sir, Srinidhi, sir?
Yes, ma'am. Yeah, why it is B?
So basically, when we talk about anything into the research, first we always try to identify that what is the existing problem which is going on, and then we try to find out that what can be the solution we can arrive to, solve that particular problem. So
yes, very good, ma'am. Very good, ma'am. Then I was looking at. Thank you, ma'am. And then I was looking at Sarfiraz sir. You spoke about you have typed A. So why it is A? Why do you think it should be A? Sarfiraz sir? Yeah? No answer? Sarfiraz sir is there? Or just typing A? Okay. Premlata ma'am, why all of these?
Hello, here I'm Premlata. I feel that research is not restricted only to a problem and a solution. Mm-hmm. To have a knowledge about particular thing, we can conduct the research. Mm-hmm. So I feel that to know something, to find out a solution for some problem, for that also we have to conduct research. So it is not restricted only to a problem.
Yeah.
To gain understanding over something, we can have a research.
Yes, very
good. Well, that's what I feel.
Yeah. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Yes, so all your answers are right, but basically all these things are missing scientific way. Can you able to see? Okay, scientific way. We have to get the solution in a scientific manner. We can't get it according to our manner. Yes, definitely I agree. Research means you have to search, you have to go through again. And just now we've discussed, it's a cyclical process. It's just not like 1 to 10. So it's not that. Right. So, but scientific way was missing in A. B also, there's no scientific way. Yes, that is also research. Yes, definitely we find a solution for the problem, but the scientific way was not there. So scientific way we have to find, research, and it should be, it should be true to the extent of that problem. We should give, good results for that. So that's the reason it should be. So scientific way with the whoever has answered C, so thank you for them, and whoever answered my question, double thanks to them, because you are the one, you are keeping presentation going on and going on. So let us move with the next one, practical approach. Okay, so please keep your pen and paper with you. We will start off with one activity, the first activity. Okay, the practical approach. I'll give you probably a time of probably 5 minutes or 6 minutes. So now you can download the Excel sheet which is given in your, which has been sent to you. That is ROL index, and you have even papers in it. So if you are a finance person, take up any two paper and fill up that Excel sheet. Okay, you can fill up that Excel sheet, or you can write it in your, looking at the Excel sheet, you can write it in a sheet. I'll be asking you, you can discuss with me, and then you can discuss with us, and then we can move ahead. Then HR, same thing. If you are HR person, take up any two article and then go through, fill up those blanks which are given in the Excel sheet. If you're marketing, again you take two article and then we go through. In the finance, I think I have given even behavioral finance. If you are into behavioral finance, you can take up, then we'll come back and we'll discuss. So time starts now. Shall we start? One of you can answer, one of the participants can answer. Can we start?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Yes, Premalata ma'am. We'll start. So now 5 minutes time. Take the Excel sheet and start doing it. Any doubt, you can ask me in between if you have doubt. Are we able to do it, or just we are, just any one of you can answer? Are we trying to do it, or we are unable to? Yes, any one participant? Are we doing it, or are we?
Sir, we are doing, but it takes time to copy paste and all such things.
No, don't do that. Yeah, just note down. Just note down important points.
Fine.
Just make a note of it. It should be
Excel sheet or in the book, sir.
You can, if you are unable to write it in the Google Sheet, no issue. You can just go with, go with writing in a paper. You can write down.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Anyone else doing it? Asmita, ma'am, are you able to do it? Are you doing it? Bharati, NS?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, ma'am, are you able to do that, the activity?
Sir,
are you trying?
Yes, sir, I'm trying, but it takes time, sir, to understand the concepts, literature, all these things.
No. Just you have to fill it up. For example, in the Excel sheet, what has been given to you?
Yeah, it says
about first one, author name.
Title.
Yeah. You can just write the author name, Mr. X so and so. Title. What is the title? And then you can just write some 2-3 lines.
Fine, sir. Sure.
I don't know the name, Micro World. Sir, can you able to do it? Yes, sir. Can you able to do it? Fatima, ma'am, can you able to do it? Are you trying?
In case of a finance paper, there is no volume and title of the paper is not there. Title of the journal is not there, first of the paper.
No problem, ma'am. It's okay. Even if it is there, no problem. We'll do that. That's not issue now. Right now, whatever is available, you just write down. Leave remaining as blank. Krishnan, sir. Krishnan, sir, are you trying? Netravati, ma'am, are you trying? Are you getting it?
Yes, sir.
Anybody could finish?
Yes, sir. I'm.
You have done.
I'm trying. Hello?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Do it, ma'am. Do it. If you're finished.
Hello?
Hello, ma'am. Finished? Can you able to hear me? Vijayalakshmi ma'am, did you complete it? Sumant Kashyap sir. Are you able to try out? Are you trying? Done? Anybody? None of you could do it?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. Yes, ma'am. Please light us upon what. How did you do and what did you do?
I just focused on four columns. I couldn't do all the things within. It's a 34 pages article.
Yeah. I agree. Yeah.
Social media and human need satisfaction. Implication okay. for social media marketing is the title.
Okay.
So the author is a Chinese author, Xian Zhu.
Okay.
It's a paper from Kylie School of Business.
Okay.
2013 year it was published.
Okay.
And the objectives of this paper was to improve the effectiveness of social media marketing.
Okay.
Then some of the congruences for need satisfaction in that particular social media marketing sector is found.
Okay.
Then some needs behind social media marketing. Why is social media marketing important?
Okay. What tools he has used? What technique he has used?
Sir, he has done it on primary data only. So he has taken focus group interviews.
Okay.
So he has tried on content-based and customized broadcast outlets are there. No, sir, there he has visited few people.
Okay.
Irrespective of gender, etc.
What kind of paper you think? You would think that this is a qualitative paper or a quantitative paper?
It's a quantitative paper. It's very clear.
So quantitative means what tools he has used? How did he analyze the data?
Regression and correlation.
Ah, so he has used regression and correlation. Yeah. So did he use SEM? No.
Structural equation modeling. So no, being using it. No.
Yeah. So only correlation and regression. Very good. Very good, ma'am. Thank you. Anyone else? Yeah. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, 1 second. Sir, I have taken a finance paper.
Yeah.
Coming for the author's profile, there are two authors.
Introduce yourself, ma'am.
Premalata.
Yeah, okay.
So, to start with author's profile, there are two authors. One is Tarun from University of New Orleans and Naka and same university. And the paper title is... Oh, 1 second, sir. Dynamic relations between macroeconomic variables and the Japanese stock market, an application of vector error correction.
Okay.
This is in the year 1995. Okay. And the citation is 345. And the article is Journal of Financial Research.
Okay.
Mainly the paper, this paper concentrates on how the macroeconomic variables, they have chosen around 6 macroeconomic variables like bond rate, exchange rate, CPI, money, call money market, and real economic activity, all those things, how it is affecting the cash flow of Japanese stock market. For that, they have adopted the vector error correction model. through that model, yes, VRC model, through that model, they have come to a conclusion that, yes, there is an effect of the macroeconomic variables in the cash flows or the money supply, money flow in the Japanese stock market.
Very good. So they have used only VECM model, vector error correction.
And certain tests they have adopted, like univariate test and correlation test, certain different tests they have adopted to check.
Okay, very nice. So is that objective meeting their test? Is that they have mentioned yes, some sir, objective yes. and the test? Yeah. Okay. So it is finance oriented. So next one.
Finance
one
quantitative paper.
Yeah. Thank you. Next one more. Somebody has already finished e-commerce. Yeah, can you light up on your paper, ma'am? Your readings?
This is Shreya.
Yes, ma'am.
Shreya from Kanpur. Sir, this topic is on study on drivers and barrier of consumer adoption towards e-commerce, option for education.
Okay.
People, author profile is Meenakshi Thanji and S. Balista. And it was published in year 2016 and Journal of Indian Journal of Science and Technology. Volume is 9, issue is 32, page number is 23-29. The objectives of the research paper is that is to collect to profile the perception of a group of respondents towards the drivers and barriers of consumer adoption of e-commerce offerings. And to my extent, they have used the research methodology. They have collected the primary data related to 100 stakeholders and they have used the random sampling, simple random sampling, and they have used the SPC software also. With the, they have used some tests like fragment test in this particular research paper, and their findings and conclusions include like the e-commerce company has to deliver some important things related to education sector. And so one thing more, do you have to explain whole conclusion?
No. I want only tools and objective. Tools and objective. Yes.
They have used the tools like this particular fragment test in data analysis and the use of SPSS software.
Yes. Thank you. Anyone else? Yeah, Shankari VR. Yes, ma'am. HR. Yeah. Anyone else? Shall I go ahead then?
Hello. Yeah. Hello, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Good evening to you, sir.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you. Wish the same, ma'am. Yeah.
Sir, myself, Shivashankari from Government First Grade College, Bidti, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
I have done a review on HR paper, sir.
Yes, ma'am. The author, year, and then we can say objective and tools. What tools they have used.
So the author is Cassandra. Yeah. And I think it's from the Los Angeles Unified School District.
Okay.
The paper title is Teachers Recruitment and Retention, a review of recent empirical literature.
Okay.
The volume is 76, issue is 2, page number 173-208. This is basically empirical review of the recent empirical literature, sir.
Okay.
They have done this paper completely based on review of the empirical papers. The main objective is to find out what are the characteristics of individual who entered the teaching profession. What are the characteristics of an individual who remain in teaching. And the characteristics of the schools and districts that successfully recruit and retain teachers.
Very good. So is it empirical one?
Yes. Yeah. Yes, sir. It is an empirical paper, sir. It is not an empirical paper. It's a review of the empirical paper, sir. It's a conceptual paper. Yes.
Conceptual based. Very good. Thank
you. Yes, yes, yes.
So now, next we move ahead with our PPT further. Okay. So we have learned now. So what did we learn? We have learned from this. So this Excel sheet, why it will help us, what way it is useful before going to tools and techniques. This paper, what you have to store is only which you like. Basically, this research, this Excel sheet, you have to keep it with you. Whenever you read any paper which you like, it's very good and it is applicable for my research, only such a kind of papers you have to keep it here. Why? Because it will act for me, or it will help me out whenever I need to refer back. When you use computer tools or softwares, it becomes very difficult to remember each and every author in it. Because, for example, for my thesis, I have referred around 400 to 500 authors. Articles. I'm speaking about 500 articles I've referred. Review of literature around 200 I've done. So 500 plus 200, 700 papers I need to remember. It becomes very difficult for me. Over a span of time, it becomes very difficult for me. So what I will do, I will, for example, out of 700, I like 100. Those 100, I will put it in my Excel. So whenever I get a doubt, whenever I'm doing some data analysis, whenever I get a doubt, I will jump over to this Excel sheet. I will read that paper, then come back and then redo it. So that's how I will do it. So you can also follow if it is comfortable for you. Okay, next we will move ahead with. Now when we are moving with tools in research, this is very important now. Now there are two division of tools in research. One is qualitative aspect, one is quantitative aspect. Now qualitative aspect, just now we did, we started collecting the data. Qualitative aspect. You can't see me because power is not there in my home. Okay, so sorry, you will not be able to see my video. So power has gone just now. Okay, so you'll not be able to see me. I think you're able to hear me, right? Able to listen? Yeah, hello. Yeah, right. So yeah, so qualitative aspect. The qualitative aspect, what we did now is a qualitative aspect. Quantitative aspect, we look at the data. Now, when we look at the data, quantitative aspect has two divisions. One is you have primary data collection. One is you have secondary data collection. Okay. So now when we look at tools, qualitative aspect, now how do we load all these materials? Because I need 100 or 500 or 700, sometimes 1,000. Literature I might have in this 1,000, but I may not use all 1,000, but I feel that everything is important for me. I will load in. But keeping it in Excel sheet becomes very difficult because it's not so easy. And second thing, what I should do, we will look into when it comes to citation, what way I should cite. If it becomes APA, what is the citation style? If it is APA, how do I go about APA? Now I have to learn everything about APA. It becomes very difficult for me when we are moving in an instant food kind of a thing. So everything we want instant. Now students also want instant and teachers also want instant. So instant answers, it's very difficult for us. So that's what this tools is going to help us. In certain ways, certain places, we can use these tools and instantly we can find solution. So when we look at qualitative aspect, when you are collecting the literatures, you should think about, is it reliable? For example, when I was writing a paper on recession, did the Indian stock market due to this US recession, did it affect Indian stock market? When I was looking at, referred to around 10 articles. Out of 10 articles, 9 articles says no, it did not affect any. India did not get affected out of US recession. But one article says some Reddy, author is Reddy. So it says that yes, India got affected, and he started explaining about what tools he has used, how India got affected or Indian stock market got affected out of this 2008. Now what happens, I have 9 article which says no and the 10th one it says yes. Now this becomes a problem. Then I have to start searching more and more. If I get somewhere around 50 yes and somewhere around 60 no, I will get a research gap out of it. So research gap is also one type of gap in finding the research gap is find agreement and disagreement. So when you look at that, Reddy, author Reddy paper, when you look at his research paper, it gives me reliability. Reliability becomes very problem. Can I rely on this? Can I cite this author? Okay. Next, credibility. Credibility is again citing that author. So it becomes very difficult of it. Validity. Now, for example, in case of finance, validity is very different. What happens that finance, will it remain? Whatever I did, whatever I have submitted, for example, I have submitted my thesis. When I have submitted my thesis, it is taking lengthier time to conduct Viva. Now what happens due to this COVID-19, Viva is not happening. What happens to your data? What happens to your research? Research is, you know, what is happening? It is getting diluted because in finance, every day there'll be a change. It's not the same. HR and finance, to some extent, yes. Larger extent, no. But in finance, some extent also it is no. Why? Because every day there's a changing. That too, if you fall into the case of behavioral finance and the stock market, it is highly difficult. That's why none of the researcher could able to find the best model as of now. Now, when you look at quantitative data, what the authentic data, for example, I think so. Yesterday we had a question, how to download a data from so and so. There are a lot many available data sources. Okay, for example, if you want to look at Indian data sources, RBI database, you can go to RBI database. Many of us will be knowing this. So you can go to RBI database. When we go to RBI database, you will get a lot of data in Excel. You can download it. That is the authentic. You have to cite that source in your research. Okay, so that is authenticity. So RBI downloading the secondary data from RBI is definitely authentic. Okay, CMI, can I download the data from CMI? Yes, definitely. Why? Because CMI actually gives the data to government. Many data is not recorded by the government. Government asks CMI to record it. So CMI will record all the data for government, many data. But it is very costly. If you are going for CMI data, you know, it costs you around 2 lakhs or 3 lakh rupees per annum. So instead of that, RBI database would be better for all economic data. Stock market, you go to BSE, NSE, it is available. Okay. So I think primary data, you don't need any secondary data base. Why? Because directly you can go to the first contact and then you can ask him what the suggestions or what are the feelings of him is. Is feelings of the or feelings of the respondents. Next, replication. Very important is, can I replicate? This is the very important question in the research. You should, somebody should be able to replicate, or I should be able to. That should be the way we have to write the letter. We have to write the research article. So there should be a replication. Somebody should replicate our research. Then only the citation will come into us. We get a lot of citation on our Google Scholar. Time, when you go with quantitative data, time is very important. How much time I should take? Whether I should take 10 years or 20 years or 30 years. Remember, when you're taking secondary data, okay, when you're taking secondary data, one is called as training set, one is called as modeling set. There are two things, okay, training data and modeling data. So, for example, let us say I collect the financial data, for example, IIP or maybe stock market or a GDP. So I collect this GDP data. I want to forecast through my tools and technique. I will collect for 20 years. In the 20 years, so 19 years would be training data. Okay. 19 years would be training data. The 20th year would be modeling data. So you have to train the data 20 years. Out of the trained data, you have to forecast. You have to find out what you have forecasted, what is the actual. If both meets, your model is applicable, well established. So always you have to remember, in finance, this is very problem. Primary data, no problem. In the secondary data, this is the biggest problem. You should have training data and modeling data. You should model the data. You should keep the training data. Some years you have to break some years, and some years you have to take it. So how many years? It depends upon your study. Okay. So you can go for basic minimum of 10 years. 10 years is the basic minimum for any research article is concerned. Remember, article itself takes 10 years. 5 years is okay, but 10 years would be better. So 5 years is okay. You cannot say, sir, I am taking 5 years data in finance. Can I, should I not do it? You have to do it. 5 years data is okay, valid, but 10 years is the better. Next, we look at this qualitative aspects. In the qualitative aspects, we have review of literature. Now, review of literature can be modeled through Mendeley or Zetero. This is the very good tool available for us. I think many of you would be already using it. I think so, right? So Zotero will give you only free for 2 GB. Mendeley will give you lifetime. So it's an open license. So that would help us more. Apart from this, there's one more. That is Dossier, which basically very good, but it is not online. It is not cloud oriented. It is inbuilt oriented. It's if you lose your laptop or if the data gets corrupted in your laptop, you cannot retrieve. But in Mendeley, what happens? You have the option of retrieval. What happens? You can go to cloud. You can upload your literatures that can be downloaded on the desktop. Okay. So we will look into. We'll look into how does it work. Next, once the ROL finishes, citation. Citation is very important. Now, everybody nowadays, almost all follows APA. 90% of the researchers follow APA. Now APA 6th edition or 7th edition, very important. Now 7th edition APA has come out. 6th edition is no more acceptable in many Scopus-oriented papers. So we have to now equip ourselves for 7th edition till 2019 end. We were using APA 6th edition. Now you have to go for 7th edition. Is there a big difference in citation style called as APA? Now we have MLA. MLA is very oldest, but it is available for literature people. But even nowadays, literature people are asking for APA more than MLA. Next. Plagiarism. When you look at plagiarism, there are two well-established softwares available. One is Turnitin, other one is Urkund. Now, Indian government accepts Urkund as the recognized software for all universities across India. Turnitin is not recognized by government of India, but it is well reputed. So it is it is always better. First we go for Turnitin, then we go for Urkund. I will tell in a span of next slides, I will tell you why I prefer Turnitin than Urkund. I will tell you, probably many of you would be knowing it already, why Urkund is not so effective as of now. Next, we move ahead with the review of literature. Okay, so under review of literature, we have Mendeley and Zotero. And have you all downloaded this software? Any participants? Have you downloaded this software?
Yes, sir.
Yes. How many of you have downloaded? Probably 10 or 20. You already know how to use it, or you want me to?
Sir, Mendeley, if you can do it once or yeah. Any.
Yeah, yeah. Mendeley, I can do it. Zotero also, I can do it. But Zotero, I have not sent the, yeah. Mendeley will do it, definitely. Yeah, you can also join. You can also do it with me. Along with me, you look at the screen and then minimize and then try. Can we do it like that? Okay. Yeah. Let me show you about Mendeley now. So, yeah. So, to practice Mendeley, can we have this paper with you? We have to search this paper. Please make a note of this paper since you have accepted. So loyalty programs as instruments of marketing investors sentiment and stock returns. Okay, anyone out of this, you can type it in the Google Scholar. We will go to Google Scholar. Okay, so can you able to see my screen?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Srinidhi, sir, please yes. Show the title once, no, please?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. 1 minute. Come on. I'll show it. Yeah. Any title you can take. It's not that this title only you have to do it. I've just, for learning purpose.
Done. Thank you.
Yeah. So let me also copy from here. So have you made this Google Scholar like this in your web browser? Have you made it like this? Can you able to see my web browser? have you made it like this? You have to make it like this. Sir. It's always good if you make it like this.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So now, let us input. And have you done the web plugins of Mendeley here? Can you be able to see this? Have you done this? You have to do this. This would be ideal. Have you done this? There are two ways you can do in Mendeley. One is offline, one is online. So this is through online you can do it. In the case of offline, you can download. For example, this paper, I can download it offline and then I can upload it to the Mendeley. So two way I can do it. So if you have done this, this becomes very easy. If you have not done, we'll try to even learn from offline. It will take some time. You can visit to your library if you have created. Have you created here login ID and other things? You have to create here. Once you download, you have to create here login ID and then go to tools. Okay, I have already installed Word plugins. See this. If it is say install Word plugin, please install this. Okay, this will help us a lot. So if I say uninstall now, I will my Word plugins would be uninstalled. So if when you look at this, if it says install MS plugin, please click on that and install your Word plugin. That is very important for us. And second most thing, when you look at it, citation style. See, I've already done APA 7th edition. So please, all of you, try out. Are you getting 7th edition like this? If not, there's a trick.
Sir, I don't have Mendeley, so I should download it now?
Yeah, it becomes very difficult, ma'am. You can just look at this and then note down the steps. Later on, you can try.
Okay.
So write down, you can look at the steps and you can make a note of it and then you can download it later part and then you can try. If not, I'm available for next 15 days. You can call me, you can talk to me. Okay. So I can clear your doubts.
Yeah, sure, sir. Thank you.
Yes, ma'am. So all of you, are you getting this 7th edition? Or if you're getting APA 6th edition, what are you getting it here? If you're getting 6th edition, please let me know.
I'm able to get 7th edition.
You're able to get, very good. Good, Priya ma'am. Anyone else? 6th edition, who's getting? If you're getting 6th edition, you have to go to more style. There, here, you have to search. You'll get it here. Or else you have to type here, automatically it comes in. Then you have to select it. Okay. So then by default, it will come here. Citation style, 7th edition. Any doubt here? So now when we go about here, we are going to now, we have come to browser here. In the browser, you can see here if this web plugin is there, it would be very ideal. It will basically takes into consideration. Okay, so you can look at it whichever I want, whichever the article I need. So for example, I'm looking at this is PDF is available. Okay, this PDF is not available. Still, I can do it. I can do it here. This PDF is available. Since PDF is available, it will show you here PDF is available. Okay. Okay. So I have a PDF here. Click on this. Okay. Click on this. Then please check. Remember, Mendeley acts sometimes like different mannerism. Okay. So once you click on that, please click on the title. verify once, is everything has come. This is very important for us. Why? Because when you go to Word, it becomes difficult for us to cite this author and put it in the referencing. Okay, so once again, I'm repeating, you should have this web importer. Okay, in the web importer, you click on whichever you like, okay, whichever article you are looking at, whichever you feel it is good, click on that. Once you click on that, please reconfirm once again. Okay, so is it a journal article or okay, everything is reflecting properly, everything is come. Look at this, everything has come. Okay, if it has not come, okay, then what you can do, you can choose the folder. I have a lot of folders here. Okay, I have a lot of folders here. Okay, I have interconnected Zotero and Mingle, so I can even access my Zotero files in my Mingle, so that way I've interconnected. So that's a different issue that we will talk later part. So let us say, for example, I want to put, I don't have anything, I can put it directly. Or let us say, for example, I'm just storing it. Always remember, you create a folder in your Mindeley. How do I create a folder in Mindeley? You go to online Mindeley account. Okay. You go to sign in. You have to sign in first. Okay. Now, once you sign in, go to library. Okay. In the library, please create. Do not create anything in the desktop. It becomes a little difficult. If the interaction between internet problem or anything, it may cause problem for us. It's always better we work in the cloud. And then we download it to our desktop. See here, you can see here it is downloading now. Okay, so it's always better, do not do anything with this. Do not, okay, even offline you can upload it here, but do not do that. Always go to cloud. This is the mistake, because one of my friend who's doing PhD, who's completing PhD, they have done this mistake. So they came to me when they were citing, there's a problem. So when they came to me, I told them, no, do not touch this. Do not touch anything desktop Mindeley. This is desktop Mindeley. Do not touch this. Okay, and just what you have to do here in desktop Mindeley, one is install Word plugin, then citation style, then your login credential. Apart from this, do not do anything here. Anything you are doing, please go to your cloud. Okay, there you can do. See, for example, you can add, create, you can create a folder. I can create a folder here, marketing. Okay, marketing. For example, I'm writing article on HR, finance, marketing at a time. So, or in finance, I'm writing behavioral finance separately, or stock market, or accounting paper, cost accounting, based on cost accounting, or bills receivable, something paper I'm writing on those things. You can create separate folders. Okay, it's always better create a separate folder, put it. For example, I will take up some papers only for some methodology. I don't refer for any other thing apart from methodology. So create a folder, put it as methodology. Only those you have to remember. That is very important. When you go to Google and Google Scholar, and when you do it here, you have to remember, okay, this paper should go to methodology. Okay. So, or else also you can do it. You can come back and then you can send it. You can, move it. Okay. You can add it to some other folder. You can do that. But still, while creating primary, respondent would be better than secondary respondent. Okay, this is second respondent moving from here to some other folder. This would be the primary respondent for us. So primary would be better for us. So check once. So for example, I'm taking some other, see here. Can you able to see the mistake? What Mindeley is doing? I should not directly see. Look at here. I'm taking this. Let us say, for example, I want to recheck. I want this paper to be in my Mindeley cloud. I click on this. When I click on this, what happens? See here what is happening. When you go for citation, when you do the citation in the Word, there'll be error. And what happens in your reference? This will be an error in the references. Then what happens? Your Scopus paper, Scopus journal will reject. Why? Because these bugs are coming in. So this I have to remove. Okay. When I remove it, I need to look at it. See, there's no year, there's no volume, there's no month, there's no day. Abstract, don't worry, we don't need. Okay. Okay, these are all okay. DY, if you have, you can automatically it will take DY. If it is not there, it will not take it. See, so these things I need to manually load it at the primary instance. Remember, primary instance is always better than secondary instance. When you go here, you can see here, see something at all, it will show now. For me, since I have not done these properly, it will show me, you know, some citation problem. So it is always better. Once again, I'll repeat. You have to first download your desktop Mendeley. From desktop Mendeley, open an account. Okay. Once you open an account, okay, you go for install Word plugin. Okay, install Word plugin. This is very important for us. Then go for citation style, APA 7th. If I'm seeing APA 6th, go to more style. In the more style, you have to search, or you can just type it APA 7th edition or American Psychological. Automatically it will come 6th, 7th, 5th, 4th. Okay, in that we have to select 7th. Okay, why? Because we are not supposed to use 6th from January 2020. Okay, still India accepts, but we are not supposed to if you are going for a Scopus global papers. Any doubt here? So once you are done, don't do anything here. Come to your cloud account. In the cloud account, you go to Google Scholar. Once you, whatever the paper you want, you check and import in the web plugin. You click on that, automatically it will recognize all these papers here, and it will also tell me whether the PDF is available or not. You can see here, PDF is available for this paper. Along with this paper, the PDF will also be recorded in your cloud account. Okay, and from the cloud account, what I will do, I will say sync, automatically it will start syncing. It will download here. So please do not touch this Mendeley desktop except installing Word plugin and adjusting your citation style. Okay. So once you do this, for example, in this paper, you see, you double click on that, you see journal article. You see here, yeah, here has come one paper which we are looking at too. Here was not there, no? Yeah, this is the paper. See, journal article, okay, managing customer loyalty. In that, see, there is something has come which it is not supposed to. Okay, what is this? Journal has come out, journal name has come, publisher name has come here. So that should not come. So this has to be deleted. And then, or else we have to cut, paste it. So year 2009. So 2009 you have to put. So if you don't know what to do, click on this. When you click on this, you will get APA styling. You can copy and paste. I think this much you can do it. Okay. Then you go for add. Once you click add, automatically it will come here. It will come here. It will come in all documents as well as it will sit in your preferred folder. Preferred folder. Any doubt in this? Yes? Yeah? Anyone of you are there?
Yes, sir, I have a doubt. I have not used Mendeley till now. Is it only for the articles which is there in Google or for the articles which have already been downloaded?
You can even upload that also. For example, let us take, for example, I have here, can you able to see my desktop?
Yes, sir.
You are able to see these folders? And yeah. For example, let us say I want to upload this file, okay? This PDF document, this I don't have, I want to upload it. I can do it. Okay, what should I do? Always do not touch your desktop Mendeley. Go for your cloud Mendeley. Okay, go here. Go to add. Okay, sorry, 1 minute. You can import it. You can import. New entry. You can enter all those details. Okay. And then you can drag this PDF file. You can paste it here.
Okay.
So it will automatically, you know, takes that PDF into consideration.
Okay. So thank you.
Okay. So that is one thing you can do it. Okay. So you have to go for manual entry. Manual entry. You enter everything. You just drag it here and put it here. Automatically it will take. Then you go for save. Once you save it, you go for your desktop. You can here also you can do it. Here also you can add it. See, here also you can do it. I can add from here also. Okay. I can add and then sync. Either way, I can do it. But it is always better to do from one side. So remember, one side it is always better. So you can even do it from here. See, for example, add. I can add it here. I can take anyone here. Okay. And automatically it creates its citation styling and other things. Accordingly, it will create. Once you have to check, once verify whether all the required information have been filled or not.
Okay, sir. Okay. Got it, sir. Thank you.
So any other doubts we have on Mendeley? Okay. Then we go with the next one. Okay. So, can anybody answer? Research work should be based on primary data only, secondary data only, none of this, both primary and secondary data.
I think answer? It is D, sir.
B, secondary data only. Very good. Thank you, ma'am.
Sir, D.
D. D. D. Both primary and secondary. Yeah. Right. Yeah. So, research should be always primary and secondary both. How it is primary and secondary? Can anybody tell me how it can be primary and secondary? Yeah. Can anybody light upon
the primary and secondary?
Yeah. One of you.
Primary is collecting from the source, and the secondary is collecting from the publications,
existing data,
from the secondary sources, second hand information.
Yes, definitely. Yes,
from the second hand. The second hand information is called as secondary.
Very good. Very good. So both will help us, because for conclusion, for findings, no. For conclusion, definitely it will help us a lot, and even in the analysis it will help us a lot. Why? Because in the analysis you have to bring out the reason for each output, so for that it will help us a lot. Next we move ahead about citation style. Now there are two citation style we have understood. As of now we knew APA 6th edition. Now we have to step into APA 7th edition. So October 2019 is the date of APA 7th edition, but we officially started using from January. Okay, so till December, all the articles were accepting 6th edition, but India, I don't know. We look at Indian perspective, whether still they accept 6th edition or so. The reputed journals in India may accept 7th edition, they may not accept 6th edition, but maybe UGC CARE listing, some of the journals may still accept 6th edition. According to their perspective, we have to go ahead. So now when we look at it, we have to remember 6th and 7th both. No, why? Because we learned just now Mendeley. So after this citation styling, I will show you in the word how you can cite as well as you take your references. Okay, many of us will be knowing it. So once again, it is a revision for us. If we know, if we don't know, it's a learning for us. So in case of 6th edition, title of the page, how it should be? It should be double space, center aligned. As usual, there's no change between 6th and 7th. author name, title page only. Again, in the 7th edition also, it is same. Short quotation. Remember, if you are quoting as it is from the paper, okay, as it is definitions from another person. So fewer than 40 words. Remember, it is fewer than 40 words. In-text citation. Sometimes it is called as in-text citation. It is called as, okay. So fewer than 40 words. If it is fewer than 40 words, we go like this. We go with inverted comma, quotes. We go with quote, and then we say Rama 2019, page number is must. Remember, page number is must if you are going for a short quotation, which is the word, the quotation should be, the definition should be fewer than, less than 40 words. Okay. It should not be 40 and above. It should be less than 40 words. Okay. Or you can go with API 6th edition. What were you doing? As Rama, okay, 2019 found page to page 15 to 16. 15 and 16, it is may come from 15 to 16, it may end up. Similar manner in API 7th edition, it's the same, almost same. Yes, not much change, okay, between 6th and 7th. Okay, or there's one change. See here, APA, you have 6th edition, you have only two. In the 7th edition, you can quote like this. Okay, at the end, page number will come. Here, page number will come. I have missed it out. Okay, so in 2019, Rama said that is possible in APA 7th edition, that is not possible in APA 6th edition. Okay, next, long quotation. If you are taking word which is more than, okay, yeah, yesterday we had some queries in respect of this. If you remember, we were, we had a question whether to go for footnote, whether to go for referencing. You always go for referencing. Footnote is, if you mention in footnote, you have to go for referencing. You have to mention once again referencing. It will become a double. And if you put it in footnote, your plagiarism will increase. Okay. So your plagiarism will increase if you put it in footnote. So do not write APA styling in footnote. It is not advisable because your plagiarism will increase. Okay, so it is always better put it in the reference, because when they run Urkunda Turnitin, they say exclude references from, you know, showing the plagiarized materials. So what happens, we will save that much percentage, otherwise your percentage of plagiarism will increase. So do not put under footnote until or unless otherwise the publisher will ask you. It's mandatory, otherwise do not do it. Okay, so long quotations, in case of long quotation, it comprises of how many? 40 or more words. So 40 and above would be called as long quotation. Out text citation, it is in text, it is out text citation. So discusses the, you can, you, what were we doing in the sixth APA 6th edition? We were presenting it like this, page number 15, or like this way. But in 7th edition, is it the same? Yes, almost the same. Not much difference between 6th and edition in case of long quotation, but there is a difference between short quotation. We can use this way so that the flow comes out. So the flow, to bring the flow of our, you know, research, we can do it. Next one. Yeah. Next, citation styling, font and margin. We have here only terms New Roman 12 point. Remember, font and margin, we had only 12 and 1.5 spaced with 1-inch margin all the side. Now, remember, as soon as you start writing an article or a research paper, please first you frame your, you know, make a template in your Word. Create one template, okay? Create one template and then start filling it up. Otherwise, you write it in Word, but you should have a template with you. You start pasting from your, whatever your flow of writing to Otherwise, it becomes a little difficult. Why? Because your numbering is the problem. Numbering. I'm in thesis. This is very important for thesis than the paper. When you're writing in thesis, what happens? Paper, page numbers is the biggest problem in thesis or MPhil dissertation. What happens? Page number. When you look at your, you will create one index file document separately and you create your flow separately, and then you start looking at it and you'll start writing, content. You'll start writing the page numbers of the content. When you go to the printer, the page number is changed automatically. But always remember, you go for auto, content. Auto content. Automatically content should come. So that way you have to do it. Probably if time permits tomorrow, I can show you. If you don't know, if you know, I don't want to show. If you know, I can show you how you can auto content. So table of content, automatically it comes. And acronyms, your, acronyms, how it can, you can reflect on the word automatically. I will not do anything. Automatically as I input, the acronym will come in its position. That way also you can do it. So once you automatize, what happens, it becomes very easy for you, for your research paper, for your, not your research paper, thesis. That is very important. So that is very important for the thesis. So don't go for manual filling up of table of content or table of graph or table of tables. Okay. A content of tables. Okay. It's always better go for automation. It's available in Word. So many of us might know. So if you don't know, I can help you, or I can teach you that also. Next is the font and margin, APA 12 point we are taking. Here we have a lot of other fonts have been added. You can look into. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. 4 fonts have been added up. So here only one font was there. So you can have, but remember, you cannot have first paragraph in Times New Roman, second paragraph in Calibre. Okay. So the entire thing should be either in Calibre or Arial or Times New Roman. Any one font. Okay. You cannot have like that. Okay. So I will design it, sir, different way. It looks very nicely. No, you cannot keep it. You have to keep only one font size and one font and margins. Okay, all this. So 1 inch is the margin. Here also 1 inch is the margin. Numbering of pages. Okay, so each pager is numbered on the top right corner. Remember, it is on the top right corner. You have to put the page number. Here also, out of APA 7 also, it is the same. Top right corner, you have to put the page numbers. Okay, use of et al. This is very important. Et al means others in Latin. Okay, so in case of 6 or more authors, in APA what we are doing, in case of 6 or more authors, we used to include only the first author followed by et al. No, when, be careful. In the APA 6th edition, what were we doing? If it is 6 or more authors, for the first time, you have to mention all 6th authors. All 6 authors you have to mention for the first time. Then consecutive time onwards, you have to mention et al. In APA 6th. Edition. Remember, in APA 6th edition, if there are more 3 or more or 6 or 7, whatever so number of author, for the first time you have to mention all the name of the authors. Second time onwards only you can use. Second time you are citing the same author, then you can go with et al. First author name and then et al. In case of APA, if it is 3 or more author, first author, et al. First time itself, in the first instant itself, in APA 6th, first instance, you have to mention all the authors. In the APA 7th, first instance itself, you have to start, if 3 or more are there, 3 or more authors are there, then you have to start et al. Okay. Next, reference tips. Okay. So entry should be arranged in alphabetical order. Okay. So principal author, that is the first author would be coming. Then DOI should be mentioned. Then use ND. For example, you will get an article. I think one ma'am was telling about, sir, I didn't get the year in which he published. So in that case, author name, and you can write ND, not dated. you can please write, you have to mention this. So if no publication date is available, okay? So otherwise, author, publication year, title, sources, you can write. Any doubt on the citation? Shall I move ahead? Okay, reference tips. Okay, now you have to identify and tell me what is the difference between APA 6th and 7th. Please read it out and put it in the chat box. I will check the answer in the chat box. Yeah. Answer? No one has answered?
The word retrieved is there in the sixth, sir.
Very good, very good.
We can't find it. Who's in seventh?
Who's this?
Premalata.
Yeah, Premalata ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Thank you. See, in APA 6th edition, you have retrieved is there. Now there is no retrieved. There's no retrieved. Look at here. This is the minor difference where the Scopus paper or most reputed journals will not accept. We do this mistake of retrieved and then they say we will not accept your article. Why? Because we have done. Referencing is very important. Remember, always when you start verifying the journal, we start from our references. They start, basically they start checking references.
Patrons.
Then next one. Next one.
Patrons.
Okay. Yeah. So please tell me the answer for this. When you're planning to do a research, it is better to approach the topic, do pilot study, familiar with the literature, forget about theory because it's a very practical undertaking. What should be the answer? Yeah.
I think C will be the right one.
First
one, A, C. Okay, let us look into C. Yeah, C is the answer for it. So yes, definitely first step is always yes, we are new to the field, then automatically yes, first answer is right. Why? Because I don't know anything. I am starting the first time. What I will do? I approach, I think something and then I'll start reading it. Okay, when initially I started learning about, you know, reading about review of literature, I used to sleep. Why? I used to read and then sleep off. My own experience, I used to see some mathematical, you know, or econometrics equations. When I look at mathematical or statistical equation, I used to sleep off. Now, how did I understand this? Remember, always don't jump to your PhD, you know, thing. When you start, first write an article. One article you write in that area, automatically you will start getting the interest. So first you write, no problem. Let me publish in D letter paper. For example, it is in the care listing, it is D, but I'm publishing, no issue, no problem. First time you write one article, once you understand the intricacies of it, automatically you will start learning it. Okay, so don't think about, so always first step is open-minded. Yes, once you understand automatically, I started learning then how to apply these econometric tools, how to apply these SPSS, how to apply R. So now I find very interesting and within 3 minutes or 4 minutes, I can complete one ROL. Okay, so 3 minutes or 4 minutes. Is it possible? Yes, definitely possible. 3 minutes, 4 minutes. Yes, you can do it. Once you, you know, get a hang, once you get the experience of it, automatically you can do it. So right, definitely, so open-minded, yes, definitely we'll approach in the first instance, but finally we end up in going with the C. Next. Okay, in case of ebook formatting, if you have downloaded an ebook or we have read Google Books and then we have, you know, through the Google Books, we have directly through Web Importer, we have applied this. And then the Mendeley, in Mendeley, automatically this citation will come and, you know, reference will come and it will be there, it will be stored. So now how do we do this? In case of APA 6th, again, same thing. Okay, retrieved is there. Now here, this is not there. Okay, that is only in case of 7th edition. That's only the change. Okay, in case of APA, tabling of APA, you are tabling your, data analysis. How do we go for tabling? Use always Indo-Arabic numerals, that is table 1, table 2, table 3. Below that, all should be left. Okay, all should be left. Below that, go for, okay, naming of that table. Okay, And then if you have like this first level, second level, go with that. Okay. And then if you are copying and pasting, for example, this table I have pasted, I've copied, and then I've taken it. So mention the source. In the analysis, it should not come. Sources in the first chapter, if you're going for, okay, in your thesis. When you go for first chapter, you may bring in a lot of, you know, reports, lot of tables, lot of pictures, then you can quote source, even in your articles. Now, when I, you know, went through this Indian Journal of Finance, when my, you know, paper got accepted, they asked me lot of questions. So when that lot of questions, they asked me, can you tell me the source of this tables, what you have done? And I had done one Markov chains modeling. So they asked me, Markov chains, this graph, can you tell me, did you do this graph, or is it the output of your data, or is it copied from online, since I have not mentioned the sources? So then I told them, no, it is out of my, you know, application part, out of my data, the Markov chain graph has come out. So then they told me, you have to put a source. What is the source? Source from research scholar, or source from the author. That should be there below the graph, if that is not there. And they asked me further, can you give the data? I told them, yes, I can give the data. So that is very important for us. So in API styling. Now, for example, this table is very huge. I can't accommodate in one sheet. Can I go for the next sheet? Definitely you can go to next sheet. Okay. How do I go to next sheet? In case of, now you cannot do horizontally, you cannot divide the table into horizontally, but you can, you know, segregate the table into vertical manner. So vertical manner, what happens? I will go with like this. Table one continued. I will give the same caption here. Okay. I can do this automation in the Word. I can do it. Okay. In the Word, I can do this automatically. I need not to type again. Automatically, the Word will only do this caption, and then the continuation part it will do. So this is the table one continued part. So again, same heading should come. Whatever heading we saw here, whatever heading we saw here, this heading should reappear here. It is not appearing here, but it should reappear. Okay. So the page number should be on the top right corner. When you're going for the, you know, graph, you go with these graph. Remember, our graph and the table should be totally different. Remember, it should not be same. Sir, like BBA project, my table will come, my graph will come. No, never. That's the low level of doing, low quality of doing. Your graph should address some other queries. Your table should address some other queries. It should not be table and a graph together. You should not analyze. This is very important. Remember, I think many of us know already. If we don't know, please keep a, make a point that graph should address different matter altogether, and the table should address different matter altogether. It should not be for every table I should have a graph. Not at all. Sir, can I have one graph? Definitely. Sir, I can have graphs, some few graphs, few tables. Yes, but it cannot be graph related to that table. It should be related to something else. Any doubt on this? Any doubt on this? Oh, one more question. Yeah. So why do I assume that no answer means Maunam Samati Lakshanam? I assume that if you are keeping quiet, I assume that you have understood. Next one. Why do you need to review the existing literature? Okay, answer please. Anyone to enjoy reading the academic research on the selected topic to reach the required word count? So I need to, a minimum 200 pages thesis, minimum 1000 words. Yeah,
it's yes, ma'am.
See, to find out what is already known. Yes, you all know now. Yes, very good, very good. So you're all better than me. Yeah, so word count, never go for word count. Remember, since plagiarism has come out, your thesis should not be, or it can be less than 200 pages. Even 150 pages of thesis is well accepted. Do not say that, okay, 200 is must. No, not at all. Because of plagiarism, it is not so easy to write on your own. It is not so easy. So since the plagiarism is playing the around, all the universities are accepting. If you can say my thesis is around 120 pages, it's accepted. Okay, so don't worry about the pages should run into thesis. And in coming to, you know, article, maximum I think 3000 words, 4000 words maximum they accept, somewhere around. Okay, so yeah, so don't go for it, go for this. So to find out what is already known in the area of interest. Next one. Okay, next we are moving on to plagiarism. Next tool is about plagiarism. Plagiarism, according to Oxford Dictionary, blah, 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 has been defined. Okay, someone's idea, I will steal. Okay, so yeah, definitely we have discussed already. You told me, sir has already discussed about different types of plagiarism. Probably I will not discuss on all those types. Okay, so plagiarism, there are two ways. One is Turnitin, one is Urkund, we discussed already. Turnitin is well reputed, very 5-star rating. Urkund, definitely star rating, but I should not discount because the government of India has accepted. Good for us, actually, why I will tell you later on. Okay, so it is not publicly, I should not, or online, I should speak about this. Urkund, yes, good. So which one is better? So Turnitin would be better option for me than Urkund. Urkund, what happens if you do it in Urkund? What happens second time when you take it to the university or you give it to the publisher, it shows that you have already done, that it will be recorded automatically, it will be stored in their cloud. So in case, for example, it is thesis, in case of thesis, if you have done in Urkund and then you take it to the university, you give it to them, what happens? They will check. When they check, it will show so-and-so date, so-and-so time, so-and-so IP address. This has been already plagiarism checked. Then it becomes a problem for you. So it is not so easy. It becomes a problem for you. Why? Because university will ask, you know, why did you check? Then they will ask you a lot many things. So it is Urkund, you can go for only first time. Turnitin, they have an option of, you know, erasing it from the cloud. You can erase it from the cloud. Okay. So let us look into Turnitin, how Turnitin plagiarism looks like. Okay. So one of my students' project, I asked him to get it done, plagiarism through Turnitin. So somewhere about 23% is the similarity index. He got it. And in that, internet sources is 15%, 9% is publication, and 15% student paper. We have to look upon student paper, and then we have to look upon these things. Please remember, these are all very important. 4% submitted to Christ University, submitted to Pacific University, 4%, 1%, 1%, 1%, 1%. Don't worry about less than 1%. Okay? So less than 1% does not yield as much improvement, but this will definitely, you know, reduces our 23%. So when you look at your document, wherever one is written, it is all copied from Christ University. That means you copied from some other Christ University material, or Christ University material was copied by some other university member. From him you have copied and pasted in your thesis or your article. So which says number one, that means first plagiarism. That is why we never say here copy, we say similarity found. Okay, so you might have somebody was asking me in the last talk, they were asking me, sir, can I find a very new topic? It is very difficult to find a new topic. If you find new topic also, it would have been already answered by somebody. How did I get the solution for this? When I was going through this Mahabharata, a bit of Mahabharata, I would like to bring it here, cite it here. In the Mahabharata, what happens? We call it in Kannada Tithi for people who have passed away. We do that every yearly ones, death anniversary, we say. Now, Yudhishthira will ask Bhishma, why we have to do this? Why we have to do this? What is the use of it, doing it? Now, Bhishma says, yes, this was actually same doubt I also had. I asked my father. why we have to do this. Without that also, the person who is dead, we don't know whether he will get rebirth or not. Whether he is reborn or not, we don't know. Why should I do it? So I asked the same questions to my father. And my father answered me, he also had the same question. And he went in search of this and he got this, you know, reply from Agastya Rishi. So that is what the citation, that is what it is. So same way here, we would have had the similarity. So citation, the research is existing from Ramayana and Mahabharata days. So we don't know. So we are just following without knowing. Now we were getting it and then we are knowing this is the way. Okay. So now what is happening here? Similarity index 23%. So 23% is too high. It should be less than 10%. Keep it 5%, 6%. You cannot make it zero. Okay. If you make it zero, it becomes doubt whether how it became zero. So you keep it 10%. Okay, max to max, not beyond 10%. Now in that we need to look into 15% student paper. Now one of my colleague was telling me Turnitin will not show grammatical error. It's wrong. It shows. It assumes only students make grammatical error, not the teachers, okay, or not the faculties. So that is why it shows 15%. You can't find that 15% anywhere in the paper. When you go through, when you scroll down in the list, okay, this is the end report, originated this report, you scroll down, you will not find anything. So this 15% is the grammatical error what we have committed. So that is why any grammar mistake can be done only by the students. That is why, you know, student paper. So 23%, you can't keep it. And then we need to reduce all these things. So we have copied, we have plagiarized. So we have to bring it to, we have to read it. Once again, read these points, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, all these points, you read it in your, you know, plagiarized report. There'll be a colored marking, read that and then rewrite it in your own language. Then you run Turnitin, you will not get 23%. You may get somewhere around 5%, 7%, 10%, maybe 12% max to max when you rewrite it. Remember, okay? So that is why, so these things are the ready reckoner reference for us. This is a tool for us to reduce our plagiarism. So don't copy. The main intention here is not to copy paste. Main intention is learning. It should go into your head. So that is very important. So that is why it is always read these things and then rewrite. So automatically your plagiarism will come down. Any doubt on this? Any doubt on this? Any participant? Participants? Yeah. Any of the learned members? Any doubt? You have not understood? Understood? So Maunam Samati Lakshanam. Okay. We'll go with this question. So please answer. This question, plagiarism is what? To make use of work of others to gather information, to use the work of another or misinterpret. What should we do? Which is the better option for this? Answer?
B, sir. B.
B. Answer is D. B. Okay. Answer is B, D. What is the answer? I also don't know. Let us wait and watch. So answer
it is D for D, sir.
Yes, B. Very good.
D for Duryodhana.
Yes. No, it is B. Answer is B. Okay. So misinterpret it as yes. That is what the thing. So even if you cite, I'm telling you, even if you cite Rama has done so and so, Christopher has told so and so, even if you cite, plagiarism will come. Okay, so citation is not the thing. Even if I'm writing in my own language, I have read it from him, so it has come from him, I'm citing it. That's the way it should be. So I will read something, I will understand, I will write, but actually I basically am writing because of that person. So I have to cite him. Okay, so that is what called as not a plagiarism. So what should I do? I should read, then write it in my own language. That is the way in which I've understood. Not one language, here refers to Kannada or some other Hindi or Urdu or some other language. I should read in the same language, that language, but it should not be same. It can be similar, but not the same. Okay. So, and I have to cite. Why? Because I have read this information from so-and-so author. That is not called as plagiarism. Okay. Next one. Okay. Which one of these is not normally associated with qualitative data? Which one is not? Answer. Which one of these is not normally associated with qualitative data?
Maybe pie chart, sir.
Yeah, only one
pie chart
person is answering. Pie chart, very good. All of us know. Okay, pie chart is the one which is not associated. Okay, can we go to the word and we'll try out APA citation? Can we try once if you have Mendeley and other things? Can we try out, do it in the word once, and then we'll come back to the next, topic. Next topic. So we'll try once with the word. How do we do it? Okay. So we'll open a Word document. So all of you can do it. You can open a Word document. You can able to see my screen. No answer. No reply. You can able to see my screen, Word document. Can able to see?
Srinidhi, sir, yeah. Can I interrupt for a minute?
Yeah, definitely, sir.
I think one of the participants has a question. She has been waiting for quite some time.
Yes.
Shankari, ma'am, you could unmute yourself.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Gokul, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, regarding the plagiarism, I have a doubt, sir.
Tell me, ma'am.
Sir, as part of the PhD thesis, they ask us to publish two articles in the journal, sir.
Yes.
So, when we publish our journal, when we publish in the journal and then we put it on the Turnitin, even our own article, it shows that it's plagiarized.
Ah, that is right. How do you know this? Very good question, ma'am. One thing is, they will ask you to give your papers. When it comes out plagiarism, you can, if it is your own article, you can take the article and you can show them one way, and then they remove that and then they rerun the plagiarism. They exclude it when they are doing it. Okay. Second thing is, always I prefer, do not deal with your PhD data. PhD data is, for example, you are going to analyze for 10 years. Do not go with 10 years. Go with only 3 years. Go with only 5 years. Go with only 10 years. Okay. So that way it will be. And then review of literature, because why, the thing is what? Review of literature, what you are putting in your article, should be a little different in PhD thesis. Would be better. That way you can do it.
Different.
And in your PhD thesis, you can have review of literature 35 only. You can have 35. But do not put review of literature in the manner of A, B, C, D. Mm-hmm. Don't put like that. Bring in the arguments. Bring in the connect between one author to the other author.
Okay.
Here is not a matter. So you need not, always we do that in our Indian thesis. When you look at Shodh Ganga, or many, many theses in Shodh Ganga, you see Mr. Ram, 2019, Mr. Rahim, 2020, Miss won't come actually, Miss and Mr. won't come. Actually, last name should come. So, Tejas, 2019, they will list it out. Don't list out. Please bring in the continuity in the ROL. That would be better. Continuity should be there. So, one author to the author, please continue. Don't worry about the years. Sir, it should be ascending or descending. Nothing you need to worry about ascending or descending years. You can bring in 2010 or 2020 in between, but the content should be continuation.
Okay, sir.
Next question, it may arise. Okay, 35, 40 only you are telling review of literature, but you are asking us to, but the university is telling us to put 100. Yes, you can go with 100, but all 100 we don't use actually. Okay, we use 100 in a different way. Okay, how do we use 100 review of literature? We use it introduction may few, Okay. Analysis may few, and then conclusion may few. Finding may finding few, but only few of literature we use it in review of literature. Now, in review of literature, what kind of literature should be used? Remember, we have to use very, you know, for example, let us take for example, 10 years, maximum 10 years period literature only you should use it for ROL, not before that. Sir, can I use 1993 ka literature in review of literature? No, you should never use 1993. 1993 you can use in the theoretical background, theoretical framework. When you explain theoretical framework, there you go with 1993 or before 2010. Okay, so 10 years, 5 years. Actually, they say 5 years. Only 5 years relevant, related, you know, similar literature should be used as review of literature. Before that, should not be considered for review of literature. Review of literature. Before that, you can consider it. Conclusion, you can consider it. You can consider it in your normally conclusion. You should not take it. Those things, conclusion should closely relate to review of literature. Okay,
yes.
Closely relate to review of literature. But still, then you can quote it. Okay, so introduction, research methodology. Okay, gap. You can bring it. There you can bring it. There you can bring 10 years before, but they say 5 years, thumb rule is 5 years, but you can go up to 10 years for review of literature.
Okay.
Any doubt, ma'am?
Okay, sir. Thank
yes, ma'am.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome.
Sir, this is
yes, ma'am.
I have a problem.
Yes, tell me, ma'am.
Sir, jab review of literature, you told us that there should be continuity. Sir, I have read also about that there should be some theme types of continuity. So,
yes.
Does it mean the same thing? Okay.
Yes,
it
yes, yes.
And then we should continue like that.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. There should be a link between what first author is telling, what second author is telling. So if
these could be different, like evolution trends, like we are talking about such things.
No. Review of literature is directly connected to your title. So
okay.
Your title, you should speak about more about your title.
Okay.
More about your title, not on the themes. Your theme is only one title. It should speak on the title or different objectives. It can speak on different objectives also. You will have different objectives. So on those objectives, it can speak. Review of literature can be framed into. It is better if you divide according to objective wise. So you have 10 review of literature related to one objective, 10 to another, 20 to another, 30 to other, put together 50, 60, 70, no problem. Okay, least is 35. Least is 35. Yeah. Highest is 100.
Yes,
not beyond 100.
Yeah, thank you so much. Thank you.
Any doubt? Any still doubt you have, ma'am?
No, sir. Thank you. Thank you so much.
You're welcome, ma'am. Anything else? Yeah. Shall we go with the word and we'll try out? How to do this. Have you opened a Word document? Shall we go for citation? Shall we try for citation? See, I have Zotero also. I have Mindeley. Where is Mindeley? Mindeley will come in references. References. In the references, you see here. This is the Mindeley. Okay. So I have why it is not happening for me? Because I have not opened a Mindeley. Let me open it. So I have to open this Mindeley desktop. Then only this Mindeley will work. Okay, done. I did not do this. Yeah. Now see here. My citation is ready. See here. APS 7th edition is ready. Anybody is finding difficulty? Or are you able to follow me? Yes, any one of you? Are you able to follow me?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. So what I'll do, I will open a Word file. Okay. I will go for, in that file, my reference. In the reference, before doing this, first I have to open my Mindeley desktop. First, I need to open my Mindeley desktop. Once I open my Mindeley desktop, I can go with references. I can go with insert citation. Okay. For example, I'm going with some author called as Naka. Is it there? It's not there. So what I'll do, I don't know which author to be copied. So let me take, for example, from here, I'll copy one author. Let me, ANG, okay. Let me come back. Not still not showing. 1 minute. Let me open my Mendeley first. There's some problem with Mendeley. Let me switch off this. Yeah. So now let me go to Word. Picking it. Let me copy down one author from here and then directly paste it here. Okay, let me copy down the full author. Okay. Come here. It's not coming. It should come actually. Yeah, it has come now. Now let us say I want to mention 3-4 authors, the same language. Or on the same variations, 3 people have discussed. Okay, in one line I will quote. So, so and so has told Indian stock market not affected by 2008 crisis. Or let us say, for example, loyalty will not be, customer loyalty will not be caused due to a lot of benefits. So this has been told by many authors. So I can bring in several authors here. I can bring in one more author who has told. Okay. Even if as soon as you type, it will come. Let us see. One more author. So you can take, it will come, comma, comma, automatically it will come when you take. For example, one more author will take, for example. Let us assume that this fellow also is going to speak on the same lines of the other person. Okay. So, okay. Will come. See, there are 2 people. You can choose whichever you want. Yeah. Then second. Yeah. It should come. Yeah. It's taking differently, but actually it will come. Right now there's some problem. Okay. Now citation has come. Okay. What do we do basically? Okay, this citation has come. Now, this citation, I want the reference. I want to bring in the reference for this. I don't know the whether to follow 6th edition or 7th edition. So I am following right away 7th edition, but I don't know how 7th edition should be. So you need not to worry about this. Directly you go for insert bibliography. Automatically, alphabetical order, it will give the references. Okay, it will give the references automatically. In the order. Okay, there might be error here. Retrieved from is coming. Okay, why? Because there is some error in my this desktop version. Okay, that is why it is showing retrieved version. Okay, so otherwise, yeah, it's not there now. See, it shows review now. Automatically it went off. So there's some problem in the desktop version. That is why it is not coming. Okay, until unless I upgrade it. So like this, how do I get this? Remember, I get it. Go to tools. Install Word plugin. Through this only I can get it. Otherwise, I'll not be able to do this. So it is very easy for me. So I will cite what, see, for example, now I have here so many articles. So many articles I have here, but I've got only 2 references. Remember, there are only 2 references. Because I've used in this document only 2 references, only those 2 references will come. So this is very important for us. This is very handy. A tool comes for our, you know, level of working. It will be very easy for us actually. Okay? When you look at this. So I need not to keep on thinking about this. Okay? So I have used 10 authors, only 10 authors references will come here. Any doubt in this regard? Anybody has not understood? Understood? Anyone? Reply?
Yes, sir.
Understood? So I think that you have understood. If you have not understood, you can ask me. Still, you can ask me. Okay. So there was some problem with my, this desktop version. That's why I'm not getting two authors together. You will get two authors together, four authors together. So in one line, you can say all these people have told, yes, so and so will not cause, or so and so will not affect. So directly you can write 10 authors altogether, or three authors, five authors. So it will only basically do ascending and descending order. We need not to do. You have to just remember the author's name, keep on typing the author's name, automatically it will only do ascending and descending order. Okay, according to that APS styling. Next. So I think all of us are confident enough now about review of literature. Any doubt on review of literature? And yeah. Yes. So, and tools used in review of literature, any doubt? Okay.
No.
No problem. Okay. Now we move on with the data analysis. Now when we go, this is very important. Now, basically what we have to do, first we have to concentrate on data analysis. Do not worry about, collect few review of literature. For example, let us say I want to write some article on, you know, for example, teachers' benefit, okay, or teacher satisfaction, some title I want to do, X title you keep it. Now, when you want to do, collect few review of literature, maybe 50, 30 or 40. Run through that. Once run through that, directly jump to collecting the data. Okay. You have to start collecting the data. Once you complete data analysis, then only you will come back. Again, you collect review of literature. Again, you go for introduction. Again, you go for, so it's a reverse process. Remember, research is a reverse process. What you do, first you collect review of literature, few review of literature. You will read few review of literature, directly jump to data. Start analyzing the data. Okay. Now, once you start analyzing the data, there are two types you can analyze the data. One is qualitative data analysis. One is quantitative data analysis. Now, in our thesis, it is always better to merge both qualitative as well as quantitative, because you only answered me earlier, yes sir, we need qualitative as well as quantitative data analysis. Okay. Now in qualitative data analysis, what shall we do? In qualitative data analysis, how the qualitative data analysis? It's basically conceptualization. So what you do first, you find out certain literatures. You review it and you say what they have preconceived it among that, about that title. So what is their, you know, they're saying on that title, what they have concluded it, how they have found that to be. Next, what you do, bring in the interconnection among the opinion of the authors. So different authors have told differently. So always when you take up your PhD, it is always better start, first paper should be review of literature. You should write a paper which consists of only review of literature. Then you'll become thorough. How much paper I should refer for writing review of literature? 100 and above. Sir, if I'm writing an empirical research, how much references I should give? References is different from review of literature. Remember, reference consists of your citation, your introduction, your review of literature, methodology, wherever you have cited, you have quoted. That is reference. Sir, I should use bibliography or reference? Next question. Do not use bibliography. Bibliography means only books. So do not use the word bibliography. Bibliography means only books. Reference means books as well as research article. So you have to use the word reference. Do not use the word bibliography. So how much I should, in case if I'm doing an empirical research, I want to publish in very good journal, how much it should be? Minimum it should be 30. Minimum 30 references you should have. How much review of literature? You can have minimum of review of literature, say about 30 review of literature or 10 review of literature, which is very good. Okay. Next, so bring interconnection among opinion of the authors. So once you read it, what they think, and then you go, you bring in, you know, you make it, you bring in the continuity among what he thinks, okay, you critically examine, and then you'll start writing it. So revisit and verify these theories, what theories we speak about. So when you take a PhD, when you are entering into a PhD, okay, two things you have to do, or when you are entering into research arena, two things you have to do. First thing is writing a paper on a review of literature on the title. Second one is conceptual paper, looking at the theories, whether it is finance, whether it is HR, whether it is something else. So theories, revisit the theories. That theories will not go into waste. Why? Because in my thesis, it will come as second chapter or third chapter or so and so. In the first chapter, normally we divide in the thesis, first chapter introduction, second, first chapter may part B, we speak about theoretical foundation. So that paper will help me to bring my theoretical foundation, and it will give me hint for research question, objective and analysis. So first thing we have, what we have to do when we are into research arena, or first time we are writing a paper, go for review of literature, paper on review of literature on one topic, and go on conceptual, theoretical basic. Take the theories and then start doing it. So revisit theories and verify what the authors are speaking about. And out of these, build a research question and you draw conclusion. So you can go with interview method also sometime. In qualitative data analysis, you can go with interview technique. Through interview technique, you will get some, for example, one paper, one Scopus journal I published. I went only through this interview technique. I interviewed around 400 teachers. Actually, it is about teachers, something about teachers I have done. So I've interviewed about higher education. In the higher education, I've interviewed around 400 teachers, and all the interview, I made a note of it over phone. I had my co-authors. My co-authors also helped me, and my guide also helped me. We divided the 400, and then we spoke to them, and then we made a note of it, and then we started, looking at the theories and started building a model out of it. So drawing conclusion. So out of it, you draw conclusion. This conclusion will help you for your empirical research. This conclusion will help you for your research question. This conclusion will help you for your objective. So remember, the first and foremost, one qualitative paper in your subject or area of interest, and one review of literature will help you a lot in, knowing what has to be done further. Next. Okay, we did the activity time now. So we have done the activity. So we will go ahead with this. We have done this. We did the Word document. We learned how to do it in the Word document. So same thing here, I have mentioned it. Okay. So these two, for example, I have sent these two papers. I think these two papers also is available. You can go through tomorrow's class. We can discuss these two papers. These two papers speaks only about conceptual. So it speaks about only qualitative data. I don't think so. These two papers speaks about anything quantitative as such. So it speaks about qualitative data. So since we don't have much time now, so we will keep it for tomorrow. Tomorrow we'll discuss in the starting these two papers. You read it and come. Okay, so activity time for tomorrow, not today. Okay, so please read these two papers. Make a note of these points, and tomorrow you will teach me. I have not read that paper. I have not referred that paper. Okay, you will read it. You will come and teach me tomorrow what these two papers speaks about. Okay, and is these things are covered in this paper? Is these 5 points are covered in this paper to do a qualitative research? Yes, can we do that? I think some noise I can hear, but yeah. Can we do it tomorrow? Can we do that?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now next. Qualitative.
Shrinidhi, yes. Sir, there were two questions just before we got into the qualitative and quantitative research. I think one is from Mr. Saravana Krishnan, and after that there's one from Rohini Kalish. So I had just stopped them from asking the question since you were explaining the concept. Saravana, sir, you could go ahead with your question.
Yes, sir, thank you.
No problem.
Sir, I'm Saravana Krishnan.
Yes, sir, Saravana.
Sir, I have a doubt. Actually, I'm working on a paper. this particular paper, I'm not finding out sufficient literature of review.
Okay.
So how do I go about it?
Have you searched across all EBSCO and all other
separately individual website also I've gone through.
Okay, but how many review of literature you have got it into?
Maybe I have got around 4 related to the topic.
Okay, so this 4, is there any similar topic available? Similar topic?
No, sir. Actually, it is. If I search like that, it becomes two topics. It will be not a one topic actually. So
okay,
it goes on a different thing.
Okay, sir. What we can do, probably you can WhatsApp me your title. Let me look into that. Is there available or how it is?
Sure.
So the one is only 4 means you have to go with only 4. But how do you go for tools data analysis part when you have only 4 papers, or you have to depend only on 4 papers? Mm-hmm. What tools they have used on those tools only you have to do it.
Okay.
Or you can do some other tools. So you send it across that title, you can WhatsApp me.
Sure.
Okay, I will just look into. You give me some 2-3 days time. Okay, I will look into. I'll definitely contact you regarding that title. Is there any review of literature available elsewhere? So if not, you have no option to go with 4 paper. If you are blessed, the Scopus might accept. It might be entirely new. So Scopus paper, these kind of paper, you can publish it in Scopus papers, Scopus index journals. So they accept a lot. You can go ahead with it. Okay, one more question.
Thank you.
Thank you, Sharma sir. I think that answers your question. Rohini ma'am, your question, please.
Sir, my question also was on the same ground, sir.
Okay.
Because my topic is impact of GST, and I don't have much articles in relation to that.
Yeah. Little difficult impact on GST. I think it is available across the globe. I think I've seen it. I've seen this. They're available across the globe. Don't worry about India alone.
Sir, but relating to particular sector, sir. It is relating to one sector.
No. Review of literature need not to be sector.
Okay,
literature can be broad. Okay, so review of literature, it is available. GST I've seen, because one of my student was interested in writing an article, and he approached me, and I've told him across the globe it is available. Many review of literature on GST is available. You can go through, you can take a broad perspective. In that, few will be Indians, so those few, based on that, you can analyze and you can write your conclusions.
Similar type of literature review can be done, no sir?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Definitely have to do that only.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah. Anything else? Gokul, sir, anything else?
I think those were the questions which were in the chat box. I think that's
yeah,
the
okay. 1350. Thank you, ma'am. Okay. Next, qualitative research tool. Now, what are the tools available? For example, I have to analyze. It becomes very difficult for me to keep everything. So there is one which is open licensed, okay, QDA, this is available, or Ravan's Eye, which takes 65 languages, okay. So, but it is a cloud-based, Ravan's Eye is a cloud-based, 65 languages it considers. So you can, whenever you are free, you can look into. Right now, we will not get into this qualitative research using of tools, because it becomes very huge, and then we have to, tomorrow's also we have to go out with the next day. So it will become 3-day, 4-day, again, 7-day or 8-day, 10 days workshop it will become. So this two, you can, because these are all open license, you can use it. You can try out at your free time. How does it work? How does it takes into consideration? So you can put in all literatures or reviews. It will only give you word count, who is similar to whom. Okay, so Mr. Ashoka is similar to Mr. Taylor or not. So Ashoka and Taylor, are they similar grounds? It will only give you. So we need not to worry about it. So the tool will give me that. The best one is Nivivo. So it will all interviews you can put across. Once you put across all interviews, it will only filter your interviews. It will give you text analysis. It becomes very easy to analyze textual. You will note down the interviews, and then you will come, you will post those interviews, or you type those interviews in Nivivo, as well as literature. It can do both. It can do interviews also, textual analysis. It can give you frequency of those who have used how many same, you know, answering the same words. So that can give you. So that will be a best one, but it is premium. You have to pay 30 days or 60 days free version you will get. So, but that will not be sufficient for us. But otherwise, you can refer any of these two, which is a very handy tool to analyze our qualitative research, you know, data. Okay, so that will become very easy. So try this when you are free. Next one. Next question is, yeah, data. Does data speak? So can anybody answer this question? Yes, no, not at all. Yes, nobody is answering.
Yes, left. It will speak.
Yeah. Data yes. Definitely speaks, but not in the raw form, right? Not in the raw form. But we have to do some, we have to bring it to some other format, right? So probably tomorrow, probably today's session will be going to end. Tomorrow, I have given you one more tool. Tomorrow, while starting, we use that tool. And then we make the data to speak tomorrow. So right away, I'll go with some tools today. And then probably, so Gokul, sir, 7:30, have to stop? We need to stop at 7:30?
Yes, sir. If you are done with, of course, 5-10 minutes here and there, it's absolutely fine. But are we done for the day, sir, with the content as such?
No, I will take 5 more minutes.
Absolutely.
And then I will stop. And then remaining part, I will continue tomorrow, because otherwise it will become... For them sure. Also, already we are sitting for 2.5 hours. So it becomes very difficult. Tomorrow I can continue from here onwards, and then I can complete my tomorrow's topic also.
Sure, sir. Okay? No, absolutely.
Yes. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Next. So what is research method? That is very important when we go over tools of data analysis, when we are using the data and when we want to analyze. So it's a technique of collection of data. So how do we collect the data? Not only research method is only stops at collection of data, but we further move ahead with how to analyze the data. That is very important for us. So probably analysis of data will not be covered in these 2 days workshop of mine. Out of 4 days workshop, we are not covering up how to analyze the data. We are covering up only tools and techniques for collecting data. So that is why I've kept myself research method here refers to technique for collecting data. I'm not going ahead. We'll see if time permits later some date, same participants are willing, we can do analysis through R software or through SPSS, SPSS, eViews. Okay, I will discuss later on. Okay, so let us move ahead. Okay, so now when we look at data collection, there are 2 ways we can collect the data. One is primary data, one is secondary data. We know that what is primary data. We need not to speak much about it because all of us are okay, and we know what is secondary data. Secondary data will be in the raw form. Primary data will be in the qualitative form. We bring it to numerical form, right? So primary data we collect, so we go with some scaling. We go with some scaling. Through that scaling, we will collect it. Now, which is the best scale? It is basically Likert scale is the best scale as of now. We have bipolar rating to 10 scale rating. Okay, but Likert scaling is the best proven rating. Some people do use 7 scale of, but some of them will have their own rating scale. But for that, you have to do a lot of research, lot of data analysis, lot of validity and reliability has to be brought in to have your own scales. So otherwise, it is better at a common platform. It is already available. Likert scale would be better. So 1 to 5 would be better. So people who are answering will not have much problem, sufficient time, and they will do it. So primary data, it's a qualitative data. We convert into quantitative data. Secondary data available in quantity, we use it in quantity, but we will basically filter it out. Now when we move at it, okay, you have to identify there's something. Okay, so 2 minutes time, identify what are these whether it is primary data or secondary data, what can be applied, which tool can be applied to this topic. Identify in a minute and answer me. Nobody has done it? No participants? Yeah? Okay, first one.
Sir, for first one, it is qualitative.
Very good. It's a qualitative data. It's a theoretical, conceptual cases you are going to. Yes, next one, ma'am. Next one.
Second one, no, I think. I think it is, once again, qualitative. Maybe I doubt.
So it is not a title. It's not actually a title, the second one. It's just a study. Why? Because we don't have anything here, a study of what it is. Measures to tackle black money. Yes, it is again a qualitative analysis. We will study policies of different countries, policies of India, and then we say what policies has missed out in India. That's measures again is a theoretical background. Next.
I think it is quantitative, third one.
Yeah, that can be, yes, quantitative. Even qualitative also, but quantitative more of, you can bring in a lot of, data. What was the before demonetization, after demonetization, what happened, what is the case, what is the relationship, all those things we can bring in. Very good. The third one will be quantitative. Fourth one
is a combination of both, I think so.
Fourth one is?
Combination of both qualitative and quantitative.
Yes, you can set an hypothesis for this, the fourth one, if you want to check the quantitative, or if you want to keep it only theory, you can go for capital structure theory. If there are lot many theories, you can write only on the theory, okay, and relate to current perspective, or you will study the theory, you apply the same tools applied by the different authors, okay, and then you will say this will work, this authors won't work. So it can be looked into both the ways. Capital structure theory, yes, quantitative would be better. So combination of it is a qualitative as well as quantitative. Why? Because I will study the theory, I will take the formula and the tools out of it, and then I apply it to my data, and then I will say, is it applicable or not? Thank you. Thank you. Next one, what will we do with this? It is qualitative or quantitative?
It is quantitative, sir.
Yes, it is a quantitative. Next one.
Quantitative.
Okay.
It is quantitative. So
what tool we can use for the first one? What tools we can use? What statistical tools we can use for the first one? Evolution of our evaluation or evaluation of asset pricing model. What tools we can use? We can use CAPM model. You can use CAPM model or from our French model, we can use for the first one. Okay. If you don't know, we have to study a lot. That is not an issue. Okay. We can apply CAPM model or from our French model or a small versus big. Second one, what we can apply? Everyone knows this. Everyone knows this. Basic, even if you are done HR, if you are doing, even if you are doing marketing, you know this. You can tell the title. Based on some word, one word will help you a lot. Here only one word tells you what tool I'm using. Tell me. Correlation.
Correlation.
Very good, very good. Correlation is good.
Correlation.
Next one. Something what else? What else apart from correlation?
Regression.
As you say influence, as soon as you use the word influence, remember you have to use the regression. Yes, for the regression, basic step is correlation. Without correlation, there's no regression. Okay, so that is very important. So look at this influence. Everybody can find out. Through the word influence, you can say the tools, basic tools, what can be applied in this basic tools. What we can apply in this topic is correlation and regression. Next one. Yes, anybody? HR background? Anyone from HR background?
The correlation.
Okay, then?
Chi-square maybe?
Chi-square maybe? Chi-square, when do you use the chi-square?
Correlation, sir.
When do you use the correlation?
Unknown.
Okay, you can use chi-square, you can use correlation. Chi-square is used only when you have categorical variable. Gender. Okay. So, yes or no. Yes or no. In those cases, you will prove whether the sample comes from population or not. But that is not the case. That is not the case. Yes, correlation you can use. Yes, relationship between the culture and the job satisfaction. But can we use some advanced tool here? What is the advanced tool can be used? SEM, structural equation modeling. Because culture will have a lot of items, job satisfaction will have a lot of items. Yes or no?
Yes.
We'll have a lot of question under job satisfaction. Which gives you job satisfaction? My employer, without giving me any work, giving me salary, is a job satisfaction. My employer gives me job, but he gives me very good pay, job satisfaction. My employer gives me promotions every 2 years once, I'm satisfied. So there are a lot of items to it. Culture, yes, we follow so-and-so culture. Lot of questions to culture, lot of items to culture. So there are a lot of ingredients on job satisfaction, lot of ingredients on culture. So we can go for correlation, but correlation will not be sufficient. We have to go for SEM, structural equation modeling. Probably tomorrow I will tell you why structural equation modeling, why not something else. Okay, so I will tell you tomorrow. Probably then we may have a lot of clarity on the title. Next one, last question for today's topic. Yeah, last question. Who can answer this? Measuring Indian economic progress and analysis of national leadership through stock market performance.
So it's like a trend.
Maybe we can have factor analysis, sir.
Comparative. We can have factor analysis.
Comparative.
Very good. This is a comparative study. Very nice. Yes. Measuring Indian economic progress. Progress will tell us and national leadership. So means leaders, prime ministers will change. So how during the prime ministers, how the stock market performed. So comparative study would be more better than anything else. Okay. Any doubt here? Did we got the question? Yeah.
Sir, if there is a question like emerging trends or to check the socioeconomic impact. So
impact, the word impact is regression. The word impact uses regression. As soon as you use the word impact, regression you have to use.
Okay, and trend analysis?
Trend again, you are going to find a trend out of it. You can name trend only in the title.
Okay, sir. Right. Thank you.
Yeah. Anything else you have?
No, sir. That's it.
Yeah. Impact, influence, there are a lot of common terminologies. Okay, there are a lot of uncommon, for example, third point. We never knew there is SEM emerges out of it. Okay, so why? Because we never knew, because there are a lot of items to it. So I have to prove each item. So I will go for a SEM, multi-factor model. When it is a multi-factor model, I go on SEM analysis. I will tell tomorrow how to take SEM, when to take SEM, why to take SEM. That's what it is research about. So why, how, why, when. Okay, that's what we have to answer when we do. Actually, my guide used to tell me, actually five hows and five why. Why? Five times you have to write why. And final may sixth time you have to say how. That is your research. Your PhD is done. That's what you used to, you know, always tell me. Five times why and one time how will give you your entire PhD. So on that basis only I learned whatever I can deliver it today. Okay. Anything else?
No, sir.
Anything
you.
Else for today's?
No, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I will stop it here today. Tomorrow I will proceed ahead from here onwards and remaining how to publish a paper in Scopus. What are the requirements? That I will take it on tomorrow.
Absolutely, sir. Thank you so much, sir. And Lavanya, ma'am, over to you for the closing remarks. Lavanya, ma'am. Okay, I think there's some connectivity issue. Srinidhi sir, thank you so much for giving us a very practical aspect on the research, and with all the activities, I'm sure with the number of questions pouring in with the participants, I'm sure that the session was indeed very interesting and interactive. So that brings us to the end of day three. Thank you all the participants for actively posing your questions and interacting with our resource person for the past 2.5 hours. We have overshot our time by about 10 minutes, but I think it's worth it for it. So with that, we close the session for today, and let us meet tomorrow at 5 p.m. sharp. Thank you so much. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for all the participants. Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye, sir.
Now, may I ask the participants to leave the meeting, please? The recordings is already done.